Deep, deep in the sea, there lived little pink fish. Little pink fish spent each day merrily swimming. Little pink fish swam back. Little pink fish swam forth. Little pink fish swam up and down. Little pink fish swam sideways. Little pink fish swam in circles. Little pink fish swam in squares. Little pink fish swam and swam and swam. And for the most part, little pink fish was happy. But little pink fish was different from the other fish. Little pink fish was different because little pink fish asked questions. Why is the water salty? Where does seaweed come from? What is above the waves? Of course, little pink fish was in a fish school, but fish school is not what you think. Fish school is just a group of fishy fish that swim around together, and they don't study at all. Imagine! And when little pink fish asked questions, they just stared.
We are fish! This is a fish school! We don't ask questions! We don't blink. We don't think.
This made little pink fish very sad. Little pink fish would swim away, and all alone, little pink fish would sing a secret song.
Why am I pink? What? When? Where? Why?
Then one day, wise and kind Blowfish overheard this song. She swam over to Little Pink Fish and said,
"Yoo-hoo, Little Pink Fish! If you want to know where to go to learn something, forget about that silly fish school and go to the Tidebrary. It is run by Octopus. You must swim over the rocky reef, through the forest of waving seaweed, around the shark pool, and then down, down, down to the giant coral cave. Then wait for Octopus. Octopus will help you. Tra-la! Ta-ta!" Then she blew a kiss to Little Pink Fish.
And so, the very next day, Little Pink Fish set off. Little Pink Fish swam over the rocky reef, through the forest of waving seaweed, around the shark pool, and then down, down, down to the giant coral cave. Little Pink Fish couldn't help but notice that there were no other fish around. outside the cave, Little Pink Fish stopped and waited. Nervously. Nervous for the octopus. Nervous for the octopus. Nervous, 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 nervous. Nervous for the octopus. Then, Little Pink Fish heard a voice call out from inside the cave.
Welcome to the Tidebrary. First, you shall learn to read.
Then, a long tentacle with round suction cups along it reached out and waved slowly back and forth. And at the very tip was stuck a book. Then, Little Pink Fish heard the voice of Octopus.
A.
A. A. A.
Little Pink Fish bubbled.
B.
B. B. B.
Little Pink Fish burbled.
C.
And Little Pink Fish gurgled.
C. C. C.
That very day, Little Pink Fish learned the aqua alphabet.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, and X, Y, Z. I'm Little Pink Fish swimming in the sea. Looking at letters is fun for me.
And so it was that Little Pink Fish learned to read. After that, Little Pink Fish would wake up each day and exercise, jumping high and bending low, then swim over the rocky reef, through the forest of waving seaweed, around the shark pool, and then down, down, down to the giant coral cave.
"Welcome," Octopus would call out.
Little Pink Fish would ask for a book to read, and a long tentacle would emerge from the Tidebrary with a book stuck to the end of it. No matter what kind of book Little Pink Fish asked for, Octopus had it in the Tidebrary. Each book took Little Pink Fish on a different adventure. Little Pink Fish became an adventurous astronaut, an amazing artist, a nifty ninja, and a wild, wild western cowfish. Little Pink Fish learned many things from books and discovered that pink was the perfect color for staying hidden in the coral. Little Pink Fish learned about cities and planets and exploring and cooking. Little Pink Fish loved cooking and even cooked a whole meal for the Fishy Fish School. They had seaweed surprise, which Little Pink Fish cooked in a microwave. One day, Little Pink Fish swam over the rocky reef, through the forest of waving seaweed, around the shark pool, and then down, down, down to the giant coral cave.
"Do you have a book about flying?"
Little Pink Fish asked. Octopus brought out a book called
Beginning Flight for Fish.
Little Pink Fish read it, and the next day, Little Pink Fish read it again. Little Pink Fish read it over and over. It became Little Pink Fish's favorite book. Little Pink Fish read other books about flight, too. Sometimes the words were too long to understand, but still, they would swim around in Little Pink Fish's mind. Sometimes, Little Pink Fish would just look at the pictures. Little Pink Fish loved pictures, especially pictures of airplanes. The more Little Pink Fish looked at pictures of airplanes, the more Little Pink Fish noticed how much planes were shaped like fish. They were somewhat slim and compact, like fish. And look! Little Pink Fish had fins where wings would be. Little Pink Fish even had a tail rudder. Now, when Little Pink Fish wasn't at the Tidebrary, Little Pink Fish spent most of the time pretending to fly while swimming through the water. Doing exercises each morning, Little Pink Fish jumped higher and higher. Little Pink Fish began to dream of flying.
"I want to learn to fly,"
Little Pink Fish whispered. But when Little Pink Fish told the fishy fish school friends, they just stared.
"Fish don't fly," they said. "We don't blink. We don't think.
By the way, when are you going to make seaweed surprise again?" By now, Little Pink Fish knew that some fish could do a lot. Now, Little Pink Fish was determined to fly. One day, Little Pink Fish woke up and knew, simply knew, deep inside, that this was a special day. Little Pink Fish exercised, jumping high and bending low. Then, Little Pink Fish swam over the rocky reef, through the forest of waving seaweed, around the shark pool, and down, 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 to the Tidebrary and asked for a flight book. Octopus brought out the most beautiful flight book Little Pink Fish had ever seen.
"It's a new acquisition," Octopus said, and smiled.
Little Pink Fish read the beautiful book happily. And it was overflowing with wondrous words and pictures. Afterwards, Little Pink Fish thanked Octopus and then bade Octopus farewell. Little Pink Fish swam higher and higher, closer and closer to the surface of the water. Little Pink Fish felt lighter and lighter and more ready to fly than ever before. All at once, the word takeoff flew into Little Pink Fish's mind, and a ray of sunlight pierced through the water, and the next instant, Little Pink Fish was flying out of the water. Little Pink Fish felt very, very happy. Little Pink Fish flew above the waves, feeling weightless and free, full of flight. After so many days of reading and practicing, Little Pink Fish knew what to do. Fins stretched outwards, Little Pink Fish flew through the fresh ocean breeze. Little pink fish soared until the blue-green surface of the water below changed to the green and browns of land. And then little pink fish flew some more. And then, gently, a little shakily, little pink fish glided down, down, down to the ground.
I flew, it's really true. Oh my, where am I? What should I do?
And that was the day that little pink fish made a very special friend outside the ocean blue. You.